Welcome to the quick intro to digital trial presentation for trial attorneys, presented to you by DCM, Digital Case Management. Hello, my name is Ken Reeser, and this is the first in a series of educational videos created specifically for you, the trial attorney who is using digital trial presentation for the first time, though can be helpful to anyone who wants better control over their digital trial presentation. The goal is to show you how to best exploit the newest member of your team, your trial presentation technician. Briefly, for those of you who might still be wondering, I'd like to address the question of why you should make the leap to digital trial presentations. What do you have to gain? The answer starts with time. A professional trial technician will save you time when presenting exhibits. Time saved means more time for more evidence supporting your case and less time for jurors to drift off and lose the thread. The other important benefit is clarity. A professional trial technician can clearly present to the jury the crucial details in any document, picture, or video. This helps the jurors recall the evidence more clearly when deliberating 5, 10, or 15 days later. The underlying lesson of this video and the other videos in this series is this. You, the trial attorney, do not need to learn how to use the software. You need to learn how to use a trial technician. My goal is to help you exploit the full potential of both your technician and the technology. In most trials, most of the exhibits are documents. Please note that you can show more than one document at a time. You can put up two side by side at full size, or put up to four and bring them forward as needed. Photos, or images, are just another type of document for TrialDirector and are displayed in the same way using the same tools and features. You also have these two wide area zones at the top and the bottom of the screen, which might be useful for panoramic images, such as these. This is a call-out. We do call-outs to make a paragraph or a passage large enough for a jury to read. If it is not called out, the jury can't read it. I can call out as many sections as I can fit on the screen. If there is one technical term you should learn and use, it is call-out. I can call out from different documents simultaneously, perhaps to compare conflicting statements. By now, someone is asking, what about highlights? We can do highlights, of course. But keep in mind that highlighting alone does not make a section readable. You might be able to read these words sitting comfortably at your computer about 18 inches from the screen, but a jury at least 15 feet from a projection screen in a courtroom, often more, will not. You still need to do a call out. But you can highlight within a call out, which I recommend in documents with very dense text, for example. There are several other annotation tools available, boxes, circles, arrows, and things like check marks and question marks, etc. Your technician might suggest one or more of these when going over your planned presentations before trial, so it's always a good idea to discuss your plans with your trial technician. After documents, deposition transcripts are the second most common form of evidence presented to a jury, usually in the form of an excerpt. And you are the owner of this business, Designs for Science and Learning, correct?
Yes, actually I'm a design consultant, and Designs for Science and Learning is my doing business as title.
But let's say you only have the transcript and no video. You can still put the transcript text on screen for the jury to read along as you read aloud. This example is, in fact, two excerpts from different sections of the same transcript, as you can see by the highlighted page and line numbers.
I want to, what is your emergency?
There's a fire in our kitchen.
What's your address?
We're at 125 Main Street.
Don't forget that any audio or video file can be synchronized to its transcript, such as a 911 call or voicemail. Of course, any video or audio evidence can be presented. Vacation video, cell phone video, industrial video, security video. Just get your video to your trial technician to check for formatting issues as soon as possible. Video exhibits are always appreciated by the jury.
Okay, these are two little parts that were built previously.
Lastly, for now at least, you can also present your video side by side with a document and make use of callouts, highlights, etc. while the video is playing.
And I think I described it earlier in the from the...
And this has been your quick introduction to digital trial presentation. I hope you found it informative. If you like this video, please be sure to hit subscribe to keep up with the next videos in the series. And don't forget, please click the thumbs up button just below the screen. If you want to know more about our services, click the link in the description below or call DCM, Digital Case Management, at the number shown here, or visit our website at www.digitalcasemanagement.com. Find the Contact Us page and send us an email. And most of all, I thank you for watching.